गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दीपाली मैम हियर. आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद लेसन नंबर 2. इज मैटर अराउंड अस प्योर? हियर आई हैव रिटन अबाउट द सब्सटेंसेस. प्रीवियसली आई हैड रिटन इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड अबाउट द एडल्ट्रेशन. प्योरिटी मीन्स द थिंग विच इज़ विदाउट एडल्ट्रेशन, मीन्स विदाउट मिक्सिंग ऑफ एनी इम्प्योर सब्सटेंसेस, दैट इज कॉल्ड प्योर. मैटर आई हैड एक्सप्लेन यू इन प्रीवियसली ऑल्सो. मैटर इज एवरीवेयर विच इज एग्जिस्ट अराउंड अस. So is that matter pure? No. Matter is either made up of compounds or mixtures. Okay. There is substance definition I have written. Matter is also made up of substances which cannot be separated by any other kind of things. Now I will tell you about the compounds. Compound is a pure substance made up of two or more elements combined chemically in a definite ratio. Mixture is, it is made up of two or more elements compounds mixed in any proportion or ratio. Means compound is also a mixture of substances, but it is in a definite ratio. Mixture is a combination of substances, but it is in indefinite proportions. Properties of compound may differ from its constituents, but the properties of mixture may not differ or may differ from its constituents. Compound is a homogeneous mixture. Mixture may be a heterogeneous or homogeneous mixture. There are different types of mixture. Examples I have written here. Two immiscible liquids, means the liquids which cannot be mixed with each other. Then comes two miscible liquids, means which can be mixed with each other. For example, milk and water. Then comes solid particles which are mixed in liquid. Then dyes in black ink. About this we will study further, means by what processes these mixtures can be separated. Here children, difference between mixture and compounds I have given. You may go through that. I am repeating the definitions also. Compound is a pure substance made up of two or more elements which are combined chemically in a definite ratio. And mixture is made up of two or more elements or compounds mixed in any ratio or proportions. Compound has fixed melting point and boiling point, whereas mixture's melting and boiling point may differ. Compound is a homogeneous mixture and mixture can be homogeneous or heterogeneous. Many other differences are written here. Now here the processes are given about how to separate the components from the mixture. There are different processes for different types of materials. We need sometimes the pure state of matter. That's why we have to go through these processes to obtain the purest state of matter. For example, first one is given mixture of salt and water. It's ammonium chloride or salt, that is NaCl, sodium chloride and H2O. They are two both miscible things, both mixed together, and we can separate them by the process of evaporation. Then second comes the mixture of cream and milk. Means milk is there, when we boil it then the cream is formed. Then how to separate or how to take out the butter from that cream? So that process is called as centrifugation. It is done with the help of centrifuge machine by churning the milk continuously, and then the butter comes out. Then comes the third process, that is two immiscible liquids, means two liquids which cannot be mixed with each other. They can be separated with the help of separating funnel, which I will show you in the school. Then two solids mixture. Here I have written NaCl and NH4Cl, sodium chloride and ammonium chloride. They can be separated by the process of sublimation. Colors in a dye, when a dye is there we have to take out different colors. It is done with the help of process called chromatography. Now where are these processes used, means where are they applied? For example, the first one, evaporation. Evaporation, many times it is done to obtain the salt from water. Like from the sea we get the salt, which is the edible salt that we can get by the process of evaporation. It is also used to separate the volatile components from its non-volatile components. That is, from solute, the solvent is separated. Now, centrifugation, I gave you already the example to separate the cream from the milk. There are other applications also. Example, it is used in the diagnostic for lab for blood and urine test. It is used in dairies as well. It is used in our washing machine also to churn the water out. Then comes separating funnel when two immiscible liquids are there. It is used to separate many times oil from the water. Then the lighter weight particles from the heavier particles. It is also helpful in that. The principle of immiscible liquid is to separate out layers depending upon their densities. Densities means it depends on the weight. The heavier weight liquid is settled at the bottom and light weight liquid floats on the top. For example, oil plus water, oil will always float on the top and water will settle at the bottom. Sublimation process means the solid directly changes into gaseous form without changing into liquid. So NH4Cl and NaCl can be separated. One forms in the gaseous state and other remains as same. So that is done. And this application is used to remove separate two types of solids. Chromatography, very very useful. It is used to separate the pigments from natural colors as well as from the blood. From the blood also different types of pigments are separated. That is done always by the process of chromatography. There are few more processes which we will proceed further. One more method is there to separate two immiscible liquids which are totally mixed with each other. That is called as distillation. Different gases from air, fractional distillation. Its application is to separate the crystals of alum. Alum can be called as Fitkari in Hindi. To obtain its purest form and to separate the impure samples, fractional distillation is done. Distillation is also done to separate only miscible liquids, but sometimes the purest form is not obtained, then that it is proceeded to the fractional distillation. For example, mineral water. Mineral water or the water used in the hospitals or in the laboratories. That purest form of water is done by the process of fractional distillation. Fractional distillation diagram is given here. To separate a mixture of two or more miscible liquids when the difference of boiling point is less than 25 Kelvin. Remember this, less than 25 Kelvin, the boiling point difference is there, then fractional distillation process is used. For example, for the separation of different gases from the air as well as to separate the petroleum products which is obtained in the impure form, then to separate said petrol, vaseline and coal. So these things are obtained whenever that time fractional distillation method is used. This apparatus is similar to the simple distillation apparatus except if there is fractional distilling column. Fitted. You can see on the top it is the cork attached and below the cork there is an area in which the impure substance is filled. Then there is a distillation flask in which the mixture comes there. If the temperature is given, means the heat is given, then vapors rise and they go in the water condenser. Condensation process, you know, when the vapors, what happens to the vapors? They directly change into the water droplets. So there is a condenser in which the vapors are moving and then they change again into the water droplets and the pure form of component comes into the jar. So that is called as fractional distillation. Crystallization is also the process which is a technique which is better than simple evaporation method. Some solid decompose or some like sugar may get churned on heating and dryness. So impurities are removed by this process. It is mainly used for the salt obtaining which we get from the seawater and especially for the separation of crystals of alum Fitkari from the impure samples. Difference between elements compounds are given, which I have already explained. Then difference between homogeneous and heterogeneous mixture, which we have also studied in the previous classes. So here I have given a homogeneous mixture can be solid, liquid or gas mixture that has the same proportion of its components throughout, everywhere. A heterogeneous mixture has components in which proportion may vary throughout the sample. Remember this, homogeneous is definite proportion or the same proportion, and in the heterogeneous mixture, the proportion may vary throughout the samples. There is uniform appearance and composition in homogeneous, and in heterogeneous, there is non-uniform composition of the element. Alloy definition is already written. Simple language, I can tell you. An alloy is a uniform mixture. It is made up of two or more chemical elements, of which at least one is a metal. An alloy has properties different from its metal, from which it is made up of. Common example, it is written here. One more example I will give you. Metallic elements like gold and copper, when they both are combined, it produces red gold. Gold and silver combination becomes white gold. Silver combined with copper produces sterling silver. So these are the common examples of alloys. Now here we start with the topic colloidal solutions and suspension. Here picture is given of the Tyndall effect, which is related with the colloidal solutions. Colloidal solutions are the solutions, suspensions, which are nothing but a mixture in which substance are regularly suspended in a fluid. Suspended means scattered here and there. A colloidal is a very tiny and small material that is spread out uniformly everywhere. Okay? Inside a solution means inside a solvent, there are particles which are spread uniformly everywhere. That is called as colloidal solution. Examples I can give you. Whipped cream. Whipped cream is also the common example of colloidal solution. Foam. Foam is a solution of gas in a liquid. The substance being dispersed would be the gas. Then comes the everyday life blood. Blood is also a type of colloidal solution. Now here Tyndall effect is given, which is related to the colloidal solution. Tyndall effect is the scattering of light as the light of beam passes through a colloidal solution. Means the particles are scattered everywhere and they are properly mixed. But when the beam of light is passed, it is spreading everywhere. So this is called as Tyndall effect. The individual suspension particles scatter and reflect light, making the beam visible. Remember, the beam of light is visible in the Tyndall effect. It is the scattering of light as the beam of light passes through colloidal solution. The individual suspension particles are scattered and it makes the beam visible. You can see this is canopy forest. From canopy forest, we have studied in the previous class, all the branches are joining each other. Then when the sunlight comes, the rays of sunlight are visible and they are scattered at the ground of the forest. So this can be the Tyndall effect example. Then fog, because it is a colloidal solution, in this also sometimes the Tyndall effect can appear. In easy language, if I explain, Tyndall effect is when light is scattered by particles of matter in its path. It makes a beam of light visible by lightening the particles. Suspension, it is a heterogeneous mixture. The particles of suspension can be seen by the naked eyes, whereas colloidal solution we cannot see with naked eyes. The particles of suspension scatter a beam of light passing through it and makes its path visible. The solute particles settle down when a suspension is left undisturbed. Then it's a suspension which is unstable. They can be separated from the mixture by the process of filtration. When the particles settle down. Now which particles will settle down? Which are heavier? The solute heavier particles, then the solvent will settle down and then suspension is formed. The suspension breaks and it does not scatter light anymore when there is filtration process done. Our last topic, physical and chemical changes. Physical, we have studied about matter also, the external things, the external changes. So when there are external changes, either in shape, size, that may be termed as physical change. The interconversion of state of matter is a physical change when there is no internal changes. These में change में occur without change in composition and there is no change in the chemical nature of a substance. Very very common example, ice into water and water into water vapor. All three states of matter are there, but there is a physical change because chemical properties remain the same, means that is the form of water. But if we compare liquid, that is water and oil, there is lot of difference between them, physically as well as chemically. Chemical changes are the result of chemical reactions, means when the internal reactions occur, that may be called as chemical changes. While a physical change is when matter changes its form only, but not its chemical identity. Very common example of chemical change is burning, cooking of food, rusting of iron, rotting of vegetables or fruits. Examples of physical change, boiling of water, melting of ice, freezing of water, shedding of leaves. So that are physical changes. Very common example, digestion of food, that is a chemical change. Cooking of food is a chemical change, but cutting of vegetables is a physical change. Preparation of salad, physical change. Cutting of wood, physical change. But burning of wood, chemical change. So this is the main difference. In physical changes, the physical identity changes, whereas in chemical changes, the internal chemical properties changes. Physical changes may be temporary, but chemical changes are always permanent. Physical changes, the external features, shape, size or the state of matter changes, but chemical properties, the chemical state of matter means internal state of matter also changes. Physical changes may many times be reversible, but chemical changes are always irreversible, means they cannot be brought back to its original form. So thank you students. Understand it properly, see it properly. If you have textbook, go through it properly, lesson number 2, and I will be sending you assignments, complete on time and submit it. Remember, your assignments, your explanation will carry the grading as well as marks for your unit test exams.